This is Topological Sort Using Depth First Search. It's the third video on a playlist following an introduction to topological sorting and a different, very intuitive algorithm called Kahn's algorithm. Before this video, you should watch those two videos and also the video on depth first search, including the stuff on discovery and finishing times and edge classifications. For this sequence of videos, I'm assuming that the graph is given to you in outgoing adjacency list format. The idea behind Kahn's algorithm was to find a vertex that can go first and work from the beginning. Of course, we could also try to find something that goes last and work our way toward the first item. To do that, we could modify Kahn's algorithm to work from the back, but I'd call that Kahn's algorithm. It might be slightly slower than before because it first converts the graph into the incoming edge adjacency list representation. That incoming versus outgoing adjacency list is the only non-symmetrical difference between finding the ordering front to back or back to front. Another way to find a vertex that can go last is to just run depth-first search on the outgoing lists until we get to a vertex with no outgoing edges. That vertex can go last. This is the same example graph that I used in the previous video, with room at the bottom for an ordering. But I'll rearrange it to make the depth-first search tree easier to see. If we run depth-first search alphabetically, we start with vertex A, and then we find vertex B along a tree edge, which I will leave thick red, like in the depth-first search videos. B has no outgoing edges, so it can go last in our topological order. Our depth-first search finishes B and returns to A, which has two other outgoing edges. If we want to, we can continue our depth-first search looking for other vertices that have no outgoing edges. But let's stop for just a second and think about what the edges from vertex A mean. In this graph, A has edges to B, E, and G, so A has to go before each of those vertices in the topological ordering. Even more than that, A has to go before any vertex that it can reach in the entire graph, either because it has a direct edge or because it has a longer path to them, like vertex D. If A has to precede E and E has to precede D, then A has to precede D. But what vertices are reachable from A? Exactly those that we will reach when we run depth-first search on A. A can go in the topological order as long as it is before everything that is discovered in the course of a depth-first search on it. If we continue the search, we go to E, then D, we see a cross edge to B, then we go to F, which has no outgoing edges, so F can go last out of the remaining vertices. When depth-first search returns to D, just like with vertex A, D has to precede everything that it can reach in its depth-first search. Continuing that search of D, we get to G, see that it has no outgoing edges, and put it after all remaining vertices. Now when we return to D, all of its outgoing edges have been explored. Everything that has to follow it in the topological ordering, everything it can reach, F and G here, have already secured a slot in the ordering after D. So D can go last out of all the remaining vertices. We continue our depth-first search. E has a forward edge and then finishes. We can put it in the latest unreserved slot. A has a forward edge and then finishes. We can put it in the latest open slot. Whenever we finish a vertex, we put it in the latest remaining unreserved slot in our topological order. We continue the search on the entire graph, not just a top level called on A. The top level search ignores B because it's already searched, but C isn't. But when C finishes, it will add C to the front of the order. Everything else is already explored, so all other top level searches will just move on. Rearranging the graph into this order, we can see that all edges go from left to right, so the algorithm worked, even though it happens to give a different order than the one we got from Kahn's algorithm. But just to clarify, exactly what is the algorithm we used here? It's super simple. Run depth-first search on the entire graph and set your topological order to be the reverse order of the vertex finish times. That's it. Because the graph is acyclic, When depth first search on a vertex completes, everything that vertex can reach has been explored. As long as the vertex is before those things in the ordering, it's set. To topologically sort, you don't really need the start or finish times. You could modify depth first search to return the topological ordering directly. Or, if you already have a depth first search routine that calculates finish times for each vertex, you could feed those values through counting sort to order them in linear time. So we've seen the intuition, but we should probably state why it works a bit more formally. Consider an edge from U to V in a graph. Any topological order for that graph has to put vertex U before vertex V. If you run depth first search on the graph, that edge can be classified as a tree edge, a back edge, a forward edge, or a cross edge. I'll include possible parentheses notation too. Notice that for tree edges, forward edges, and cross edges, the closing parentheses for V come before the closing parentheses for U. That is, for all three of those edge types, V will finish before U. So if we take vertices in reverse order of finish time, any edge from U to V will put V after U, just like we need it to be. The only problem is back edges, where vertex U would finish before V. But for depth first search on an acyclic graph, there are no back edges, because a back edge completes a cycle between a vertex and its ancestor. So don't worry about back edges. We can consider a few simple variants. If you only want to consider vertices reachable from a subset of vertices, maybe just one vertex, modify the top level depth first search to only search from that subset or that one vertex. The recursive part doesn't change. Also, just like in depth first search, if your graphs contain long enough paths, you might have to worry about stack overflow problems. In that case, you might want to use your own stack for a non-recursive version of depth first search. By the way, if you do run this algorithm on a graph with cycles, unlike Kahn's algorithm, it will return an order including all vertices. Of course, it isn't a topological ordering, which doesn't exist if there are cycles, but it can still be helpful, as we will eventually see in this playlist. Well, that's it for now. I have to go rifle through my neighbor's trash. I'm sure I'll find something great if I just go deep enough.